I'm sorry, page 713 of the hymnal. I'm just going to read this in unison, please. Almighty God, you have lived together in your elect, in one communion and fellowship, in the mystical body of your Son, Christ, our Lord. Grant us grace, so to follow your holy saints in all virtues and godly living, that we may come to those unspeakable joys which you have prepared for those who sincerely love you, through Jesus Christ our Lord. You're stuck with me. Still have a stewardship moment now, and I'm the speaker for that. So I'm going to give everybody my take on stewardship. I was asked to talk about time and talent. No, I'm sorry, time and treasure. And I have a few comments about that. I'll keep them. It's a moment, so I'll try and keep it brief. Stewardship starts with God. It comes from the heart. It's a whole realm of existence. When I came to Christ six years ago, I didn't really even know what stewardship meant. I didn't practice stewardship. It wasn't a word that was in my vocabulary. And as I walked forward there, I started thinking about how I was living my life and how things were going. And I found that if I step back and think about things that I was doing and ponder on them, I would find that I need to make some changes. Some of those changes included stewardship. Our theme for this study is, you know, time, talents, and treasure. So, talents, I never considered myself real talented. So I had to learn to know what my talents were. And I had to identify it, and I had to practice them. I had to pray about them. I had to appreciate them. I had to use them, and I had to develop them. The church came to me a couple of years ago and asked me if I wanted to be a deacon. And I thought, boy, I don't think I have the talent for that. I might have the time, and it would certainly be a treasure. So I agreed, and it's been a learning experience for me. And I'm thankful to the Lord that he gave me the opportunity to develop and grow my faith that way. Time is something something that I have a problem with. Using my time, managing my time, being on time, giving my time, volunteering, feeding others with my knowledge, what little I have, visiting others that are sick or indigent, taking time to think about the people in the world, the community that need our time to make their time better. When we come to church, we enjoy the sermon and the singing, joyful noise that Edna makes for us. We enjoy the coffee hour, and then we go home. And what do we do with our time in the rest of the week? Coffee hour, we don't hold you over until next Sunday. is treasure. That's your stuff. Everybody's got their stuff. Treasure is where your heart is. Your house, your cars, your toys, all your stuff. How many people out there consider themselves rich? Raise your hand. Don't be bashful. Very nice. Very nice. Well, we are richer than we think. The statistic says if you make $48,000 a year, you're in the top 1% of the wage earners in the world. $48,000. With wealth, of course, there's some side effects. We confuse being rich with feeling rich. As a kid, I had a dime bank, or two or three. And when I filled those up, you know, I had 15, 20 bucks. I thought, man, I am rich. I have so much. I felt good. I felt rich. Want to feel rich, one good way would be to take a minimum wage job and go back and live with your parents. See how you feel rich then. One of the other side effects of wealth is margin, what we call margin. So margin is like the freedom to spend more and the willpower to spend less. We have money enough for anything we might need. We want to take and buy whatever we want, but we have to step back and think, I don't really need that now. We're going to hold off. Mm-hmm. Self-control, one of the fruits of the spirits. And also comes discontentment. The more we have, the more we want. And we're a disposable society. When something breaks, we throw it away, we buy a new one. We spend money easily. So, in conclusion, since I took more than a moment, I'm a little long-winded, I apologize for that. I would ask everyone to search their hearts, consider what your talents are, use your talents to do the will of God, to honor God, to glory God. Use your treasure as wealth to honor and glory God, to glorify God. And take your time considering those things and use your time wisely. That's my story and I'm sticking to it. Next up.